Division of segments and angles, level 6. In this video, we will start going over examples that involve adjacent angles, angle bisectors, and angle trisectors. Let's start by going over the first example. Name all angles adjacent to angle 6. In this problem, we are provided with a diagram and are asked to name all the angles adjacent to angle 6. Recall that adjacent angles have a common vertex and a common side, but no common interior points. In the diagram, we see that angle 6 has point D as its vertex. So any adjacent angles will also have this point as a vertex. In this case, angle 7 and angle 5 fit this description. So angle 7 and angle 5 are adjacent to angle 6. And this is our final answer. Let's take a look at the next example. Name four angles that are adjacent to angle FOG. Similar to the previous problem, we are provided with a diagram with various angles and are asked to name four angles that are adjacent to a particular angle. Let's first identify angle FOG in a diagram. Notice that angle FOG has point O as its vertex. This means that any adjacent angles will also have this point as its vertex. One such angle would be angle HOG. Another angle would be angle FOC. A third angle would be angle FOB. And a fourth angle would be angle FOA. All of these angles have angle O as a vertex and share a common side to angle FOG. So this is our final answer. Let's move along to the next example. Given that ray KO bisects angle JKM and angle JKM is equal to 41 degrees 37 minutes, find the measurement of angle OKM. In this problem, we are provided with a diagram, along with a geometric relation and the measurement of an angle. We are asked to find the measurement of an angle. Let's start solving the problem by first labeling the diagram with the given information. We know that ray KO bisects angle JKM. This means that angle JKO and angle OKM are congruent, so we draw single arc marks for each angle. We are also given that the measurement of angle JKM is equal to 41 degrees 37 minutes. With this information, we now know that the measurement of angle OKM is just half the measurement of angle JKM. So we go ahead and divide the measurement of angle JKM by 2. We can divide this angle by 2 in a couple of ways. We can go ahead and rewrite this angle in decimal form, and then divide it by 2. Or we can divide the degrees and minutes by 2, as follows. Now it is just a matter of simplifying this angle. Notice that we have 20.5 degrees and 18.5 minutes. Let's rewrite the half degree into 30 minutes and add it to 18.5 minutes. We now have 20 degrees, 48.5 minutes. The last step is to convert half a minute into seconds. So let's rewrite half a minute into 30 seconds. In the end, the measurement of angle OKM is equal to 20 degrees, 48 minutes, 30 seconds. And this is our final answer. Alright, let's take a look at the next example. Name the congruent angles. Ray RO bisects angle NRP. In this problem, we are asked to name the congruent angles given that ray RO bisects angle NRP. Recall that an angle bisector will split an angle into two congruent angles. Since ray RO bisects angle NRP, it will split it into two congruent angles. In this case, angle NRO is congruent to angle PRO. And this is our final answer. Alright, let's try the next example. Name the congruent angles. Ray XT and ray XV trisect angle SXW. Similar to the previous problem, we are asked to determine which angles are congruent given that ray XT and ray XV trisect angle SXW. Recall that angle trisectors split an angle into three congruent angles. In this case, angle SXT is congruent to angle TXV, which is also congruent to angle VXW. And this is our final answer. Okay, let's take a look at the next example. Name the angle bisector. In this problem, we are asked to determine the angle bisector. Looking at the diagram, we see that angle FJG and angle HJG have matching arc marks. This means that these two angles are congruent. Notice that ray JG divides these two angles. This means that ray JG is the angle bisector of these two angles. And this is our final answer. Alright, let's move along to the next example. Name the angle bisector. The measure of angle POK is equal to the measure of angle MOK. In this problem, we are provided with a diagram and are asked to determine the angle bisector given that the measurement of angle POK is equal to the measurement of angle MOK. Recall that if two angles have the same measurement, then they are congruent. We can show this on a diagram by drawing single arc marks for each of the angles, as follows. Now it is just a matter of naming the ray that bisects these two angles. In this case, it is ray OK, and this is our final answer. Let's take a look at the next example. Find angle XTZ if ray TZ bisects angle XTY, and angle XTY equals 60 degrees. Here we are provided with a diagram and are asked to find angle XTZ given that ray TZ bisects angle XTY, and angle XTY is equal to 60 degrees. Since ray TZ bisects angle XTY, we know that angle XTZ and angle YTZ are congruent, so we can draw single arc marks for each of these angles. We also know that angle XTY is equal to 60 degrees. Since an angle bisector splits these two angles equally, we know that the measure of angle XTZ is going to be half the measure of angle XTY. In this case, the measure of angle XTZ is equal to 30 degrees. And this is our final answer. Alright, let's end the video with a final example. Given the diagram, what ray bisects which two angles? In this problem, we are provided with a diagram with various angle measurements. We are asked to determine an angle bisector and name the angles that are bisected. To solve this problem, we need to find two angles that are congruent and share the same ray as one of its sides. Since this figure represents a protractor, we know that it measures 180 degrees. Notice that angle HOA is a straight angle and is bisected by ray OC, since it splits this straight angle into two congruent right angles. Also notice that angle COB and angle COG are congruent since they both measure 70 degrees. These angles also share ray OC as one of its sides. This means that ray OC is also an angle bisector of angle GOB. In the end, ray OC is the angle bisector of angle HOA and angle GOB. And this is our final answer. In our next video, we will go over more challenging examples involving angle bisectors and angle trisectors.